last Friday of 2023. Welcome to Somalia's premier number one station for news and updates, Dalson on TV, 29th of December 2023. I'm your presenter, Abdulrahman Yusuf. Tonight, have a quite a full bulletin prepared for you, but our lovely viewers kindly first have a look at some of our top stories. Regional football competition kicks off in Mogadishu. Portland State President Rabisha's off resume talks between the federal government and Somaliland. Somali National Disaster Agency delivers essential relief supplies to orphanage center in Mogadishu. Artemis troops in Dinsor facilitate the self-delivery of aid to locals from Al-Shabaab attacks. Glad to have you back. Now let's delve into our full bulletin. In a colorful ceremony, Somalia's Prime Minister Hamza Abdi Barre launched the regional football games in Mogadishu Stadium. Senior government officials, including NISA Director Mehad Salad, Mogadishu Mayor Yusuf Hussein Jim'are Madale, and renowned musicians Big Buha and Dayah Darnoshe, also graced the opening ceremony. Here's the full story. In a colorful ceremony, Somalia's Prime Minister Hamza Abdi Barre launched the regional football games in Mogadishu Stadium. Senior government officials, including the NISA Director Mehad Salad, Mogadishu Mayor Yusuf Hussein Jim'are Madale, and renowned musicians Big Moha and Dayah Dalmurshe also graced the opening ceremony. The first match of the tournament ended in a stalemate between Galmudug and Irshabel State. The Premier underscored the instrumental role regional games play in enhancing the integration and cohesion of the Somali people. He added that the games will also act as a source of entertainment for the public. The tournament is being participated in by four regional member states and the Banadu region, excluding Puntland, which has had a sour relationship with the federal government. Notably, also absent from the competition is the SSC Katumo, which was recently recognized as a state in Somalia by the federal government after seceding from Somaliland. Football in the post-Civil War Somalia has seen a commendable growth in the last 5 years, with the Horn of Africa country priding itself with a league that includes foreign players from Kenya, Nigeria, Ghana, Uganda and Cameroon, among other African countries. Construction of world-class stadium in the October 2022 Under-17 SACAFA win is among the accolades gained by the Somali Football Federation. President of the semi-autonomous state, Saeed Abdullahi Jeni, is highly critical of the resumed talks between the federal government and the breakaway region of Somaliland. While announcing his candidacy bid in Garowe on Thursday night, the president of the oil-rich region criticized and condemned the resumption of citing Putin's absence from the negotiations.
President of the semi-autonomous state, Saeed Abdullahi Jeni, is highly critical of the resumed talks between the federal government and the breakaway region of Somaliland. While announcing his candidacy bid in Garowe on Thursday night, the president of the oil-rich region criticized and condemned resumption of the talks, citing Puntland's absence from the negotiations. Since February, Puntland leaders have been entangled in border disputes with Somaliland, raising tensions. During this time, both sides accused each other of escalating the deadly conflict in last Arnold between the SSC Khartoumo forces and the Somaliland army. On Thursday, President Ismail Omar Gele of Djibouti hosted President Musa Bihi Abdi and President Hassan Sheikh Mohamud to facilitate talks between the federal government and Somaliland. Somaliland declared independence from Somalia in 1991, but has yet to get international recognition.
Somalia's National Disaster Management Agency delivered essential foodstuffs to Girls Orphanage Center in Bondere in the nation's capital, Mogadishu, on Thursday. The relief supplies are the agency's efforts to help and support the vulnerable individuals in society.
The Somali National Disaster Management Agency delivered essential foodstuffs to the Girls Orphanage Center in Bondere in the nation's capital, Mogadishu, on Thursday. The relief supplies are delivered according to the agency's efforts to help and support vulnerable individuals in society. SODMA officials who handed over the consignment of aid expressed their unwavering commitment to bolstering support for the needy people in the community, especially the orphanage center, which provides and caters for the welfare of the Somali girls deprived by their parents. The center's management thanked the agency for its timely response, saying that the humanitarian aid will go a long way in alleviating the girls' plights in the center. The center provides care for hundreds of orphan and vulnerable Somali girls. According to UNICEF, about 1% of Somali children are double orphans, while those categorized as single orphans comprise 9% of the children. The incidence of children living in households without their biological parents has been rising over recent decades and is even higher when they are older.
The Africa Union Transition Mission in Somalia personnel stationed in Dinsor Forward Operating Base facilitated self-delivery of humanitarian aid to internally displaced persons and vulnerable populations in Barawi and its environs. According to a statement from ATMIS, the troops protected the locals and aid from Al-Shabaab attacks.
ATMIS personnel stationed at Din Sod Forward Operating Base facilitated the safe delivery of humanitarian aid to internally displaced persons and the vulnerable populations in Barawe and its environs. According to a statement from ATMIS, the troops protected the locals and aid from Al-Shabaab attacks. On the other hand, ATMIS military and police officers, along with Somali National Army Police and officers drawn from the Somali Police Force, conducted foot patrols on Monday to counter the risks posed by terrorist groups in Arbriska, Lafole, El Ishibya, Hawa Abdi and Hormuud in Southwest State. ATMIS said the patrols are part of its ongoing security operation to protect local communities and major supply routes. Southwest State is among the regions where Al-Shabaab has a huge presence and stages unprecedented attacks on local communities and security personnel as part of their efforts to destabilize the security of the regional state and the entire country.
Lovely viewers, that colorful story from Din Sod brings us to the end of our bulletin. We should thank my Delta Media fraternity colleagues for making this news edition a success, and you, a lovely viewer, wherever you're watching us from. Always rather stay blessed and kindly stay put for more stories in our subsequent bulletins.